I'm Marthe, the gal in the cube, and in this video, I'm gonna connect Fabric to Purview so that I can actually view all the stuff. I can see the metadata, the lineage, the items. I can see who owns it, so I know that I can ask Adam or Patrick if I can get access to stuff, make my life easier, create some beautiful data products for myself, and just give you guys the best content. Now, when you connect Fabric to Purview, you're actually connecting the Fabric tenant to the Purview tenant. So they're gonna talk to each other, and there are some live connections here. So there's a bunch of great stuff that we can take advantage of. But first of all, we have to actually register Fabric as a data source inside of Purview, because you can connect Purview to any source you want. But you know what? Enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. Inside of Purview, there's two main solutions that we're going to use when we're working with data governance. That is the data map and the unified catalog. Now, the data map, this is where we actually connect your physical data. This is where your technical people will be and work and care. While the unified catalog, that's the logical layer. So this is where we create the data products. We have governance domains, and we also have usually business user type of roles. So we're gonna work with the physical data now. We're gonna connect to Fabric. So let's open up the data map. Now here you see we have a domain, and in order to connect, I need to create a collection. You should care about how you set up the collection structure. It's not something you should just do, because the collection structure is going to decide on the access level control of the metadata later on. So we can talk about that in a different video. For now, I'm going to create one where I'm going to collect all my Fabric stuff. You should give it a very good description and also give it a collection admin. Of course, that's going to be me, myself, and I. Now we have created a collection. Now if I click on data source here, you're gonna see that we now have this map set up. So we have the default domain, and we have a Fabric collection, and now I'm ready to register my data source. You see here, there's a bunch of different data sources that we can connect to. We are gonna connect to Fabric, which also includes Power BI. So I'm gonna click that and continue. And here you see that we're connecting to the tenants. Purview and Fabric, they exist in the same tenant. I'm gonna choose the default domain. I'm gonna use the Fabric collection. And then I'm gonna click register. And now we see Fabric being registered as a source. Now we haven't actually done anything more than register the fact that we want to connect to Fabric. What we now have to do is create a scan. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna give that scan a good name. You can decide to include or exclude the personal workspaces. I'm gonna decide to exclude those. There's no reason for me to have that in here. And if I scroll down here, you see something interesting. We see here that we have set up this SAMI, so System Assigned Managed Identities, already created for me, that's now connected to my Purview account. So that's the Guiding Cube Enterprise Catalog. Now I'm gonna need this managed identity in order to give Purview access to Fabric. So it's not enough to just set everything up in Purview. Obviously, we have to go into Fabric and tell Fabric that it is okay that Purview is accessing that metadata. If we go into Fabric or Power BI, open up this using the admin portal, because we're connecting the Fabric tenant to the Purview tenant. So we're on tenant level. You go to the tenant settings, and then I'm gonna search admin APIs to just find them for me, and make sure that service principals can access read only admin APIs. So that's enabled. But I also need to open up the enhanced admin API responses with detailed metadata. So I'm gonna click enable. That's already enabled for the entire organization, so that's okay. And then I also want to enable the enhanced admin APIs responses with DAX mashup expressions. But here you see that we have to actually add a specific security group for this to work. That means that we have to add the managed identity that we have here in a security group. So first of all, we have to create a security group. So let's do that. So you go into Azure portal, you open up groups, create a new group. And I want this to be a security group that works for my service principals. So I want the group type to be security. I'm going to give it a name. And this is where also you should use a very good naming standard. So I'm going to call it Enterprise Data Catalog. You could give it a good group description. I want Microsoft Entra roles to be assigned to the group. Now I'm going to give it an owner. And of course, as the gal in the cube, I'm going to add myself. And as a member, I want to add the managed identity for Purview. So that was Guy in a Cube Enterprise Catalog. And then my group is ready, and I'm going to click create. And now my group was created. If we go back to Fabric now, we can then add the Enterprise Data Catalog group. I'm going to click apply. And now it could take 15 minutes for all the Entra connections and all of that beautiful things happening behind the scenes to work. So I'm going to go and get some coffee. And I'm back after 15 minutes. Now let's see if it works. Let's head back into Purview. What I can now do is just click test connection. Let's cross our fingers. Oh, it's a success, it's green. That means that we're now able and ready to scan. So I'm gonna click continue. And here is the thing, you could decide to scope your scan and decide to only pull in parts of the workspaces and scan that, but I want to scan everything. So I'm gonna say no, let's scan it all. You could also set up a recurring scan if you want this to scan every week or every month or every whatever, but I want to just try and do this once. So I'm gonna click continue and then save and run. Now, if we head back into monitoring here, we can now see that the scan has been scheduled and it's running. Now we're gonna give it a couple of minutes. So we're gonna fast forward this for you guys. Now, after a few minutes, you see that it has completed, but with some exceptions. So if we open up view details here, we can then take a look at that. We see that it took 6 minutes to scan. We can open up the scan to take a look at the details. If you click here, you see that we have some run details here. We see that we did a manual scan, it was a full scan, and we discovered almost 1,500 assets, and we classified 140 of them, and we have some metadata ingestion and metadata discovery that failed. Now, I can also download a log here, so we can dig into even more detail to see what failed. That's gonna give us an Excel file that we can take a look at, and here you see the specific items inside of Fabric that failed, and also why it failed. Usually, it got something to do with the format, maybe something was not updated, it was a wrong format or an old format, or it got something to do with some access levels that needs to be configured. Now, if I open up the domain itself and take a look at my Fabric collection, you see now that we have some assets here, and I'm now able to actually discover them, understand what exists here. So if I go into the unified catalog, click at discovery, go into data assets. So now I'm finally ready to discover all the amazing things that already exist inside of the Fabric workspace using Microsoft Purview. And then I can ask Adam and Patrick to give me access to stuff and so on. But there's more things you could do in Purview. We could and probably should create some data products that we can govern, have control over, make sure that we're building things in the right way, make sure that they're trusted and reusable across our beautiful GynaCube tenant. But I need to know from you guys, do you want me to continue down this Purview road? Let me know by hitting the like button on this video or comment somewhere below. And as always, remember to hit the subscribe button and check out all the other awesome videos from Adam, Patrick, and myself. And we will see you guys in the next video. Bye!